Hey, real estate investors, James Wise. We have another Ask James Wise episode. Today's question comes from Alpav29. Dear James, I don't want to waste your time, so as quickly as possible, here goes. Was looking at certain houses on the west side, duplexes for 30 to 50K, went and talked to my bank and can't get FHA loan, even with 10% down. My credit is at 525 with $1,300 a month in variable income. Have the 10%, just tell me any chance or just rent and build credit. Let's dive in. All right, more or less, what Alpav is saying is he tried to get an FHA loan to purchase himself an investment property, but this is cool because he was gonna house hack it. So he's gonna get a loan, live in one unit himself, because to get an FHA loan, with only, normally you only need 3.5% down, but he doesn't have much income, so he was willing to put down up to 10%. But these FHA loans, these are amazing for house hackers. You buy a property, only 3.5% down, you live in one unit, you have a tenant live in the other unit and pay your mortgage, so you're essentially living for free. So for those of you who haven't heard about house hacking before, I want you to take a look at this video right here where I explain how you can use this house hacking strategy to create over $1 million worth of net worth in just 10 years with very, very little money out of your pocket. As a matter of fact, you're not gonna spend more money out of your pocket in those 10 years using this strategy to build a $1 million net worth than you would paying rent at an apartment. So check out that video. Now, in response to Alpav29's questions specifically, number one, you have to get your income up, okay? There's no like magic tricks to getting a loan. You either qualify or you don't. There's like no side door way to get one of these loans. So what you need to do is you need to make yourself qualify. Step number one, increase your income. $1,300 a month, that's not very much income. So you're gonna need to get a higher paying job. You're gonna need to get more income. Once you've established that, then step number two, you need to fix your credit. 525, that's a very, very low credit score. So let's work on fixing up that credit. Just like getting more money to qualify for the loan, there's no magic tricks with improving that credit score. There's no company you just call and you say, hey, I got a 525 credit score. Can you give me a 700 credit score by the end of next week? It don't work that way, guys. It's very, very simple to fix your credit, but you have to do this the long way. You have to do this the tough way. You just need to understand debt in general. You see, I am a kind of person that is creating a huge net worth for myself utilizing debt. I tell people all the time, debt is the best reason to invest in real estate. The use of leverage or debt, other people's money, is one of the best reasons to invest in real estate, as a matter of fact. But you have to get the right kind of debt, okay? We have good debt and we have bad debt. Over on the good side, we have things like real estate, okay? Mortgages, this is the best kind of debt. Taking out debt to build a business, that's good debt. Taking out debt to obtain a college degree to make more money. And over here, we have bad debt, your consumer debt. That's things like your credit cards, okay? Credit cards are terrible debt. We are talking about APRs of almost 30%. You are not gonna get anywhere in life if you're buying things on a credit card and then paying 30% interest. You take a mortgage, the interest rate on a mortgage is 4 or 5%, and it is tax deductible. Over here, you're paying 30% interest on something that is not tax deductible. That is terrible debt. On my Instagram, by the way, if you're not following me, you wanna make sure you follow my Instagram, at James Wise. I posted a quote about this earlier in the year. I said, houses are assets, cars are liabilities. If you own your car but rent your house, you are financially backwards. Why are you financially backwards? Because a house is an asset, you don't own that, and a car is a liability, you do own that. Why would you want to buy a liability and pass up on the opportunity for an asset? You wouldn't. So if you have a very, very expensive car payment, get rid of it. Sell that car. Buy yourself a cheap car. Use the excess money to pay off the bad debt. The only thing worse are those payday loans, and those are practically illegal. Some of those payday loans have interest rates as high as 400%. 400%. Look, if you're getting a payday loan, you already probably don't have very much money. You're in a jam and you have no way to get money to do what you need to do. So you go to a payday loan place and you take out money. There is no scenario where a person with almost no money is going to be able to get a couple hundred bucks and then have the resources to pay back that money as well as 400% interest on it. So if you're utilizing payday loans or you're purchasing things you can't afford on credit cards, you need to stop both of those practices right now, because what's probably happening is you're racking up all this debt, and that interest, it just keeps going and going and going. Your debt is higher and higher and higher, and then you can't make your payments. You're not making your payments, you're missing payments, and your credit score is plummeting. Missing your payments isn't the only thing that lowers your credit score, though. When they run your credit, people are looking at how much available debt you have and how close to that ceiling you are. So if you have, let's say, $10,000 of revolving debt available to you, but you have current balances of only 10%, $1,000, it's gonna help your credit score. Same person, $10,000 of debt, and you have revolving credit lines of $9,500. 95% of your available debt has been used. That is gonna make your score go down. So you're probably thinking, all right, fine, James, I get it. You're saying, hey, don't use payday loans, don't buy a bunch of stuff on credit cards. But what if I've already done that, James? What do I do now? Well, what you need to do now is, again, get more income, okay? If you have one job that doesn't pay you enough money for you to take care of all that bad debt, get a second job. If you get two jobs that don't pay enough money to take care of all that debt, well, guess what, dude? You gotta get a third job, bro. That's just part of the game. If you don't wanna work 100 hours a week, that's cool. I don't think that's great for the long-term strategy, but you might have to work 100 hours a week for 6, 7, 8, 9 months to pay off all your bad debts. If you end up in a situation, guys, there's nobody that's gonna get you out of it. You gotta get yourself out of it. But it's okay, because there's a light at the end of the tunnel. So you get that extra income, and I want you to take that income and just plow it into that bad debt, okay? Do not even think about trying to spend money on good debt, because your good debt, your real estate investments, real estate investors like me who've built multi-million dollar portfolios, we do not get a return of 30% or 400% on our investments. If we buy a nice investment property and that property gives us a 10% return every year, that is an awesome investment. So it makes absolutely no sense for you to spend money to try to make 10% income-wise. So your money, it's bringing in 10%. If you're just taking that money and you're sending it right out the back door at 30% or even 400%. You get what I'm saying? No point, guys. 30 or 400 is a hell of a lot higher than 10. So all your money needs to be spent paying off that bad debt. Get that debt to zero. Whether you're working 1, 2, or 3 jobs, I don't care. Get it down to zero. Now that your debt is down to zero, your revolving credit, okay, much lower, score's going up. You no longer have bills you can't pay. Your score's going up. You're still making more money because you're working 2, maybe 3 jobs. You could begin to build a surplus, begin to build some savings. Then you can go back to that bank. At this point, they're gonna be ready and willing to give you that loan, and then you could house hack your way into financial freedom. Well, Alpav29, I hope this answers your question. For the rest of you, if you have questions about real estate, finance, or anything like that, go ahead and check out the other Ask James Wise videos. If you don't see an answer to your question there, simply post it in the comments of this video, and I'll make a video just like this one answering your question.
Thanks for watching the video. I'm James Wise, co-founder of Holton Wise. If you are interested in hearing more about me and my personal story, how I turned one investment property into a management portfolio valued over $50 million, I want you to go ahead and follow my personal Instagram at JamesWiseHWPG. I want you to go ahead and click the subscribe button for more real estate deals and educational content, as well as check out some of the other videos we have throughout this channel. As always, I'm James Wise with Holton Wise, and this is real estate investing made easy.